Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with a brand new and exciting video. It's all about how to look expensive on a budget. Last time I did a video on how to look expensive, sharing more of hacks and styling tips, but this video is more on if you don't have a big budget, how do you look expensive? I think a lot of us have gone through that. I've gone through that point where I didn't have a lot of money to put towards clothes, which is why I decided for many years to only wear neutral, because it was so easy to just like always look chic and expensive all the time because I was wearing neutral, even though I didn't really have a big budget to spend on clothing. Neutrals will kind of like save your life. My style is a little bit more girly, more feminine, which I am loving right now. But I would say if you don't have a big budget to spend on clothes, this video will give you some really great tips on how to look expensive. So why don't we go ahead and get started? But before I do that, I always tell you what I'm wearing. My earrings are from Susan Shaw. They just came out with the Garden Collection. Of course, flowers and jewelry are like my two favorite things, so it's like right up my alley. This is called the Amelia pearl drop earrings. I love them so much, and my necklace is the pearl cluster earrings. I love them. And my dress is from Ishak T. It's this lace dress. What I love about Ishak T, it's kind of like a customizable website where you go, you actually pick out a dress, and then you tell them how you want it. So this dress, when I picked it out, I got this since last year, actually. Yeah, like a year ago. I don't think I've ever shared it on here, but yeah, you can pick out the length you want the sleeves to be, how you want it to be cut, and then you'll just measure yourself. So that way, well, I guess this is a really great tip. On my last video, I told you about tailoring. So this website is a really great website for that, because you actually customize your clothes from the get-go. So you don't have to pay double the money to go to a tailor and have them fix your clothes. So, wow, I didn't even realize. That is so funny. But maybe I'll stand up so I can show you the dress. It's so pretty. I love this dress so much. It comes with a belt, but I'm not wearing the belt today because obviously I am home. But it's a midi dress, and then it has this pockets over here, which I love very much. I love pockets. I'll leave the detail in the description. I'm not sure if they still have this dress. I hope they do, so you can check it out. But I really love this dress. As I said, I've had this dress for a year now. I used to wear this to work all the time. I can't believe I've never really shared it on here. So I have my notes here. So if you see me looking down, it's because I have my notes. So number one tip for looking expensive on a budget. So if you don't have a lot of money to spend on your clothes, you could probably invest in some accessories. One of the accessories is a brooch. I myself, I am not a big fan of brooches. That's because I have a fuller chest. If I wear a brooch, I just look ridiculous. Although I can get away with wearing a brooch on a coat, perhaps, I don't think it will look good on a blazer for me. It's just draws my attention. I'm not big on brooches, but I've seen it on other girls. It just looks so chic, so polished, so expensive. So I really love the idea of getting a brooch. It doesn't have to be Chanel brooch. It could just be any brooches, but I do feel like the Chanel ones are just like top of the top. So if you don't have a lot of money to spend on clothing, as I said, you could probably just invest in a really nice quality brooch, so you that way, you know, you could feel expensive and polished, and just, you know, add that. Let's say if you're wearing an H&M coat that costs $60, so you can just put that brooch in there. Automatically, it's going to elevate your look. It's going to look completely different. Next thing you know, your jacket looks like a $1,000 jacket instead of a $60 jacket. So adding a brooch to your wardrobe is, I think it's a great way to look expensive. Again, I myself, I'm not the biggest fan of brooches, but just because I'm not a fan of something doesn't mean that I don't recognize that it does make you look expensive. Again, if you have a flat chest, you'll probably be more lucky. Brooches will probably look better on you. Me personally, they don't. So I kind of like don't follow the tip myself, but I think it's a great tip for you ladies to follow. Number two is sunglasses. There is something about sunglasses. Once you pop it on, it just take you to another level. It just take you to another dimension. Like, I just don't know what it is. Again, another thing that I'm not that big, I love sunglasses, but I just find them so annoying to wear. They're not the most comfortable thing for me to wear because they smudge my makeup, they're always moving. I don't know about sunglasses, but now I do need them though because I drive and I do find myself sometime in the evening while the sun is setting. I really do need sunglasses. I'm actually gonna go to Warby Parker to get my prescription into some sunglasses so that way I can have them if I'm driving whilst the sun is setting and really, really bright. But there was something about sunglasses that just add a touch of elegance to your look. I am trying to get more into sunglasses. I do have a few designer ones. I have the Celine one is my favorite one. Oh, it's just like so classic, so perfect. I do have a Valentino, which I love very much. And then I have a few other ones. Again, it doesn't have to be designer. Like In Other Stories has some of my favorite sunglasses and they're like $30. Again, it doesn't have to be designer, but I do find sometimes when you spend money on the designer sunglasses, you take better care of it than if you buy the cheap one. That is something that I found from personal experience. Like people always say they lose their sunglasses. Myself, I just used to break them, like sit on them all the time. I think it's because they used to be cheap, but as soon as I started investing in sunglasses, that doesn't happen to me anymore. I'm a little bit more careful with that. Again, adding a sunglasses to your look will just take it from 0 to 100 real quick. So yes, if you do want to look more expensive, number two, I would say just add some sunglasses to your look, obviously during the day, not at night. Number three, it's the neutral. Again, there is something to be said about neutral. As much as I'm not wearing neutral anymore, again, because my wardrobe is more fun and girly and feminine these days, because I've already gone through my neutral phase. Again, I will always be a neutral fan. Truly and truly, like, ugh, I cannot get enough of it. Although I don't wear as much anymore. But if you are someone who's on a budget, the quickest way to look expensive all the time is to wear neutral. Like it's guaranteed for you to look expensive when you wear neutral. There is something about neutral that just take your look to another level. Of course, neutrals are your black, beige, white, camel. Camel and beige are like my favorite when it comes to neutral. Again, an all black look is, you can never go wrong with an all black look. I myself, I'm not the biggest fan of all black look because that's what most people always go for. So, which is why I like to go more for camel or the beige, because you stand out a lot more. You just look a little bit more cleaner for some reason. But then again, you can never go on with all black look. Again, neutral will save your life. It will save you time in the morning. Neutral is guaranteed to make you look chic. What I love about good pieces for neutral, you can find them anywhere for cheaper. Like H&M has a bunch of them. Zara, I don't really shop at Zara anymore, but when I use, during my neutral phase, I used to find really good pieces from Zara. There are pieces that you can get from Zara that nobody would ever know you get from them, like a good pair of wide leg pants. There's something about a wide leg pants, like you can never go on with that. H&M have some really, really great basic. Banana Republic is a really good store. J.Crew is another good store that I would recommend. J.Crew always have some crazy sale. I used to get all my clothes for work from J.Crew. They always have those like 30%, 50%, 40%. So you can always find stuff there at a really, really great price. So I would recommend shopping at the stores if you are on a budget and you want to look more expensive. Again, neutral is guaranteed to make you look chic all the time. Like, you just cannot go wrong with neutral. You cannot. And I think I highly recommend for everyone to go to a neutral phase. I feel like once you've gone to a neutral phase and once you go back to introducing like colors and print to your wardrobe, I don't know, you will have so much better understanding at picking things that just goes with you. I honestly truly owe my fashion now to my neutral phase, that now I have such better understanding with colors and style and things like that, which makes it so much easier for me now to get dressed. Nowadays, it literally takes me like not even 5 minutes. It takes me less than 60 seconds to get dressed. That's how fast I get dressed. My makeup is the only thing that takes the longest, about 30 minutes, but getting dressed, so easy, especially now since I mostly wear dresses anyways. It's like 1, 2, 3, and I am done and ready to go. Again, neutral is a really, really great way to look expensive all the time, and you can find pieces for like $20, like $30. You can find a lot of pieces under $100 when it comes to neutral. So that's tip number three. Number four, I would say, is hair. I know I am guilty of this. Me, as long as my hair is clean, typically I'm like, I'm good to go. But this year, if you haven't watched my video on things that I'm no longer wearing in 2021, I would say check it out, because in that video I also tell you my fashion goals for this year, and experimenting with my hair is one of those things. As you can see today, I've curled my hair, making more of an effort. But there is something about when your hair is nicely done, I would say a sleek ponytail. I don't know, every time I see a lady in a sleek ponytail, to me they just look so expensive, you know, especially if they're wearing a nice outfit that kind of like matches. For some reason, there's something about like a sleek ponytail that just looks so expensive to me. I always wanted to do this look, this nice sleek ponytail look. I'm not sure if it fits my face too much. I will try it. I just feel like it looks better in real life than it does on camera for some reason, but I will try it and show you guys, and then you can tell me. But again, how to look expensive when it comes to hair, I would say make sure your hair is nice and clean, and of course a sleek ponytail. I'm telling you, a sleek ponytail will just make you look so expensive. Let me know, are you do you usually wear your hair in a ponytail, or is your hair always down? Let me know, I'd love to know. Number five, of course, is having your nails done. There's something to be said about having your nails clean and not those witchy long nails. Oh my god, I can't wait for that trend to die already. There's something about having your nails clean. I would say stick with the neutral colors, like a beautiful pinky nude or a red color. You can never go wrong with red nails. Red nails just look so expensive, it just make you look so chic. And I do feel weird when I am looking really good and my nails is not done. I don't know what it is, and sometimes I'm like, I don't understand how girls don't have their nails done. And I used to be one of those girls for years. I just started doing my nails again just a couple of years ago. Again, that's when I used to be into my hustle mode, you know, didn't have time to do anything remotely feminine or girly. So I used to be in that hustle mode all the time. So I used to never get my nails done over the years, but the last few years I have been, and it completely changed the way I feel about myself. Now I don't have to be like ashamed about, you know, like handing something to someone, because sometimes I used to be searching because my nails used to just be like, I used to bite them too, they used to look so ugly, and then I'll just look so chic, but then again people will look at my nails and I'm like, ooh, I used to always kind of like hide them. So it's not a good feeling when you have to hide your nails. So I would say, you know, if you want to look expensive, just make sure your nails are done. You don't have to go to a nail shop. You can actually do your nails at home. I think especially during quarantine, we've learned so much how to be self-reliant and do things for ourselves. So again, I think in Amazon you can find the gel machines and then you can do your nails that way. But personally, I get the LCN gel done, and I just make them do it them like super short. It's not too long, you know, just a little length as you can see here, but my nails have gone, that's why they like a little bit longer now. But I typically tell them to make it like really short, and then my thing is usually a pinky nude. But again, make sure your nails are done. It's just going to change the look, it's going to change the way you feel about yourself. You're just gonna feel so much more confident, and in return you're gonna look more expensive. Number six or seven is to carry a structured bag. Again, you don't have to invest in a designer bag. Obviously, you are on a budget, you can't afford a designer bag, or maybe that's not a priority for you right now. If you are on a budget, there are like a ton of bags that are budget friendly. When I used to work all the time, my bags were like from Zara, and I had them for years. But since I don't really shop there anymore, I don't really have those bags anymore because I don't really work in the office anymore. Again, a structured bag is going to change your look completely. It's going to make you look more expensive. There's something about when a woman is carrying a structured bag that just makes her look so polished, so poised, so chic, and so expensive. And the one that I would recommend is this black one from Brahmin. Every time I want to feel a bit more expensive, I would carry this bag and automatically, oh, I just feel so good. Again, this is budget friendly. It's not too, it's not that expensive. It's a really, really, really great bag. As soon as I saw this bag, I knew I had to have it because I don't really have any black bag. And I always need a black bag in my wardrobe. You never know when the situation, you know, comes in. And every time I carry this bag, I just feel so expensive, so chic, so classy, so polished. I really, really, really love this bag. Again, you could even be wearing some black leggings and some shirt, and then you're carrying this bag, automatically you just look like a boss. And the other bags that are my favorites, that I am obsessed with these bags so much, are these bags from Staud. Again, they are budget friendly on a designer level. These bags are amazing. Like, there aren't anywhere you're gonna go where you're not gonna get a compliment on these bags. Like, these bags, everywhere I go, everyone. And also, I just feel like it's a way to look classy but modern, because the other bags can be a little bit too granny-ish. So I feel like you can still look very chic and classy and modern. You don't have to look, you know, being classy these days, it's not just about looking old school. So you can still look very chic and classy, but at the same time look very youthful. And I do find that I get that from the Staud bags, because as you can see, it's very chic, very classy. Again, although this is a Clio bag, it's just, it's structured, so it looks really, really, really classy. I really love this bag. This is removable. You can remove it. Me personally, I wouldn't, because I think that's what makes this bag so fun, is because it has that interior. Again, although this is like a plastic, which can look very, very cheap and tacky, but there is something about this bag that is like super chic and classy and look very expensive. I love this bag so much. I also got it in the white. Again, these are the bags that I used to carry and go to work all the time, and I used to get so many compliments on these bags. I just love them so much. It's just like so easy to just get my Metro card and anything that I need. I love, love, love these bags. And I love them so much where they're good for the office. They're also good for your casual outfit, and they're good with everything. That I really, really love that about them. The next one is to wear pointy toe flats or heels. There is something about pointy toe that just make you look so expensive. Try it, guys. Try it for yourself. Like, if you are on a budget, you don't have a lot of money to spend on designer shoes or invest in a pair of shoes, you can just buy any basic flats from H&M or ASOS. Just make sure it's pointy toe, and OMG, you will just look so expensive and so chic. My favorite that I would recommend are these from Sarah Flint. They are not, I mean, I would say invest in a neutral, but to me, these are like a neutral. And there is something about this color that just is just so stunning. I think I do have a Sarah Flint code if you want to check it out, so you can take $50 off any pair of shoes that you're interested in. These are called a Natalie, and oh my goodness, I am obsessed with these shoes. Every time I wear them, I just feel like a princess. Like, I do feel like a princess, or I feel like I'm a billionaire's wife or something. I just love this so much. I just feel so classy, so chic. I don't know, I feel like I'm like Audrey Hepburn when I wear these. It's just like, oh, the epitome of chicness and expensiveness and classiness. I really, really love that. Again, I would recommend a nude color, but to me, this is a neutral. I wanted to have more fun with my shoes, especially since I wear a lot of white dresses. I still wear these in the winter. If I'm just like jumping in the car and just going out somewhere to pick up food, I just wear these, and typically I just feel so good. And then the way I carry myself when I wear these shoes is just like very chic to me. I love it. And the other ones that I would recommend are the pointy toe. Again, these are from Sarah Flint as well. I will leave my code below if you want to check them out. But I would say a neutral, but a white pair of shoes are like very classy. I did not know how much I needed these in my wardrobe until last year. I'm like, oh my goodness, how come I do not have a pair of white pumps? Like, I absolutely need a pair of white pumps in my wardrobe. But of course, if you are trying to build your wardrobe, I would say get a pair in a nude color and also in the black. So that way it's gonna go with all your neutral outfits or any other outfits that you decide to get as well. So I would say pointy toe, flats or heels are the way to go if you want to look more expensive. It's going to make you look more polished, so classy, so poised. It's just going to change your look entirely. So I highly, highly recommend those. The next one, we know beauty matters. You don't have to, you know, have a cake face. You don't have to go around wearing a pound of makeup every day. You can just do your makeup simply. But I would say try on a red lipstick. There is something about when you wear red lipstick, it commands attention. It just says that I am here, look at me, I am rich, I am this, I am that, you know, I look expensive. So you can just be wearing just a neutral outfit, an all black outfit, you pop on a red lippy, OMG, it's going to completely change your confidence, completely change how you feel about yourself. It's going to change your look. So I highly, highly recommend a red lipstick. I myself, when I started my journey and wanted to be more confident and wanted to look more expensive all the time, I wore red lipstick. I wore red lipstick every day, 365 days a year. I even went to the pool with red lipstick on. And I did that for more than 7 years. Like, I spent 7 years like just wearing red lipstick all the time. The last couple of years, it's when I started going back to neutral. Because I didn't really want that much attention anymore. And also, I wanted to look more youthful. There was something I think about wearing nude and wearing blush. I think that's what I miss about when I used to wear red lipstick. I used to never wear blush. I don't like wearing blush with red lipstick. It's just too much. But I do find that when I wear blush, it just like, I don't know, it just make me look like I'm glowing. So which is why I've embraced nude lipstick a lot more. But when I put a red lippy on, it's just a game changer. It just changes something in me. I just feel, I don't know, if I feel like a 70 with this, with a red lippy, I just feel like I'm a 150. So I would say just wear a red lipstick. That's going to command attention. It's going to change the way you carry yourself. In return, you are going to look more expensive the way you carry yourself out to the world. It's just amazing. Definitely, definitely try red lipstick. There is a red color out for everyone. I know a lot of you ladies says, oh, you can't wear red lipstick. Yes, you can. There's no such thing. There is a red lipstick out there for you. You just have to try a bunch of them to find the one that matches your skin tone. Me personally, I love a red lippy that has blue undertones, which is why I love the Seraphine by Anastasia Beverly Hills and Hot Mama by the Lip Bar. Hot Mama by the Lip Bar is my favorite right now. And the Seraphine by ABH is another favorite of mine. So I highly, highly recommend those. Number 9 or 10 is to wear pearls or statement jewelry. There is something about when you wear pearls that just make you look so expensive automatically. People are just gonna assume that you have money when you wear pearls. It is true. They're going to treat you like a lady. It's, I don't know, there's something about pearls that just give the vibe of just money and opulence and affluence. I don't know. And there are some great price point of pearls that you can get out there, like the ones that I'm wearing from Susan Shaw. I think these are like $68. That's a really, really great price for a really, really nicely made pair of earrings. And all her jewelry are made in Texas, I believe. So made in the USA. So I really love that also. Again, pearls and the nice statement earrings is completely gonna change your look. It's going to make you look more expensive. You can just buy a nice statement earrings for $5, but because it's a statement earring, it's just going to take your look, you know, to another level. It's going to make you look more expensive. Again, it's going to make a statement. I would highly, highly recommend wearing pearls and a statement jewelry or earrings and necklace and so on. So also when it comes to statement jewelry, earrings and necklaces are like the two that I would recommend. For me personally, it's mostly earrings, but here and there sometimes if I'm wearing something that has that is strapless, then I will wear a statement necklace. But most of the time I prefer wearing my statement jewelry and in my ears. So wear pearls or statement earrings. That's going to make you look more expensive. And the last one is to wear wide leg pants. I don't see enough recommendation of wide leg pants out there, and I don't know why. There is something about wearing a wide leg pants that just take you from 0 to again 100 like so quickly. I am telling you ladies, please try it. Please add a pair of wide leg pants to your wardrobe. It's absolutely necessary. It's essential. You need a pair of right leg in your wardrobe. What I love about right leg, if you're short, it makes you taller. If you're tall, it makes you look even better, especially for someone like myself who has kind of like long torso. My hips are like so low. I love like a high waist wide leg pant because it just make me look a lot better, because when you have a long torso, sometimes it shorten your height. Like I could be the same height with my friend, but they may look taller because they have a shorter torso and their legs are longer. But me, I have a longer torso, or like a good sized torso, so I may appear a little bit shorter but with the same height. So a way to hide that is to wear a pair of wide leg pants. It will completely transform your look automatically. I would say if you have some skinny pants on, just try it for yourself. Just add a pair of wide leg pants, see how much expensive you look just instantly. It's going to change your look. Nothing against skinny pants, I'm not a big fan. I don't like skinny pants at all. It's just, they just don't do it for me. But again, a wide leg pant is completely going to change your look. It's going to make you look more expensive, more classy, more chic, more polished. So yes, be sure to try out all the suits. Let me know what are some of your tips to look great on a budget, to look more expensive. Those were some of my tips. I know I'm probably missing some of them. If I am, just leave them in a comment below. Let me know if these tips were helpful. Again, thank you again so much for watching. I will catch you all in my next one. Bye bye.